Hello everyone, today we will be covering the sketch tools in FormIt. Click the pencil icon in the standard toolbar to activate the icons for all of the sketch tools within FormIt. And let's start by selecting the line tool or typing the letter L as the keyboard shortcut. The red circle indicates that you are drawing on a work plane, which by default is the ground plane. So click once to place the first point of the line, and as you move to locate your second point, you will notice the dimension string, and that your cursor will snap to the red x-axis, the green y-axis, and the blue z-axis automatically. Once you have determined the direction of your line, you have multiple ways to locate the endpoint. You can use the grid snaps and click when you get to the proper dimension. You can simply begin typing the distance to bring up the tool options dialog, which is also activated by the tab key, and you may type your dimensions there. You can click the OK button or hit enter to lock in your dimensions. There are a variety of ways to type in your dimensions, and they will default to the units set by the project. In this example, I'm using imperial units, the traditional number, feet, number, inches. You can also forego the feet and inches and simply type two numbers with a space between them. The first number will be read as feet and the second number as inches. If you type a single number alone, it will be read as feet, and if you only want inches, you can type 0, a space, and then the number of inches, or only the number with the inches symbol following. As you can see, the line tool will create a chain unless you press escape once, which will keep you inside of the tool but unchain your next point. Next, I will show you the offset line tool by selecting the icon or typing the letters OL as the keyboard shortcut. When determining the points, this tool functions exactly like the line tool, but the center line is in red, meaning it is a reference line. The two blue lines are what will be drawn, and they are offset from our beginning red reference. After placing the first point, start typing the dimension for the length of your line to show the tool options dialog. As you can see, there are new options. The first will dimension the length of the line. The second is the overall distance between offset lines, so 1 foot means the lines will be offset 1 foot from one another, and the alignment is the location of our drawing path from which the lines are offset. Let's change this alignment to see what happens when we go to the left, and then also the right, and then let's hit OK, and click to complete. Press Escape to unchain the tool, and a surface is created for further manipulation. Next, I will show you the arc by 3 points, also activated by the keyboard shortcut A. Just as the icon shows and the tool name suggests, this action requires 3 selection points along the arc. The first point is one end of the arc, and as you move to select the next point, you will see the two other red reference circles, which indicate the remaining points that need to be determined. The second point is the other end of the arc. And now if you move your cursor, you will see a preview of the arc with a red dot reference point at the location of a half circle based on the diameter you drew. Click to select your final arc point to complete. The next arc tool is Arc by Center and Radius, with a keyboard shortcut of AC. In this tool, you will first place one end of the arc, followed by the radius reference length. And as you see, there is a dashed line, which means it's not drawing a line, but rather a reference to the center of the circle. The second point is the reference point to carry the arc around. When going to place the third point, you are locked into the radius you drew and free to choose the degree length of your arc. Next, we have the Spline tool, which is going to work just like the Line tool, but creates arc-based curves between the points we place. Like the Line tool, you escape to release the chain, and you can split the spline at any point by drawing another line across the spline, or by copy and pasting a vertex onto the spline. You can do this by turning on your vertices in the select icon and left window select to grab a single vertex off of another endpoint, Control C, Control V to copy and paste the vertex where you want to along the spline, and click to place. If at any point you'd like to know the length of your lines, just go over to the properties palette and select your line to populate information. If you want the length of lines or edges that are broken, like we just did to the spline, simply press Tab while hovering over a part of the line to grab all contiguous lines. Next is the Rectangle tool, also activated by the keyboard shortcut R. Place your first point, your second point will be the length of the one side of your rectangle, and then move to create the rest of the shape and notice that you only need 3 points to complete it. Just like the offset tool, these connected lines form a surface. And now for the polygon tool, which you can see defaults to a pentagon or five-sided shape. Before placing a point, press Tab and you can change the number of sides desired. So as you can see, 3 will generate a triangle, and 8 will generate an octagon. Your first point will be at the center of the polygon, and then move to select the distance from the center to a vertex. You can also change the side count and distance after the center point is placed by typing a number to activate the tool options dialog. And lastly, the circle tool, activated by the keyboard shortcut of C. This will require 1 point. The first point you select will be the centroid, and the second is the radius. Just like the offset line tool, rectangle, and polygon, you are creating an automatic surface with this tool. And that's it for FormIt Sketch Tools. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.